Thank you very much, Wim, for this really kind and nice presentation of my work. Ladies and gentlemen, dear experts of the biomass community, you see it's hard to speak for me. It's a real great honor for me and a great pleasure to get this prestigious prize, this prestigious award at this 20th European conference. Of course, you have heard from Professor van Zwaay the work which was performed during my scientific life, but you can imagine that I could not do it alone. Of course, there are a lot of people I'm very grateful that they could do this work. So I have to share this prize, of course, with my partners, with my co-workers, with the students from the university, which are working really enthusiastic and with a great pleasure on biomass topics. Of course, I'm very grateful also to the funding association. Without the money of this association, it's not possible to do this work. These national funding associations, these European funding associations, and so on. Of course, I am also grateful to the organizers of conferences where we could present our results, and especially this conference was one of the main conferences we were going here and to show our results and discuss with colleagues. So at each time I going back, I got really inspiring new ideas for my further work. Last but not least, I have to thank also the person who proposed me for this prize. I don't know who was it, but I thank this unknown person anyway. And of course, I have to thank the committee. I'm sure there are a lot of other potential candidates for this prize, and so I'm very thankful also to these persons here. Güssing was mentioned here as one of our lighthouse projects. And if you think you can plan such a project, you can plan a lot of these things, but you cannot plan the success. To get the success, there are a lot of factors which has to come together. You have to have the right idea for the right time, the right persons there, and then you have to have a lot of luck. And I know I had a lot of luck in my life. I like biomass very much, that's why I'm working in biomass, and I can follow directly the speaker before. I think biomass will be one of the key energy carriers for the future. Biomass is a peaceful energy. Biomass is distributed over the world more equally than all the fossil fuels are. So I hope at least, or I'm sure that no conflicts will arise to these biomass resources. Biomass is stored solar energy. So my previous speaker already said we need storage capacity, and there we have it from the nature. We have it from the nature. You can use biomass even in night when the sun is not shining. You can use biomass when the wind is not blowing. So biomass is really an excellent energy carrier. We need it in the future. And I will say it's a bright future for biomass, and there's also a bright future for this conference, I'm sure. This award has a twofold value for me. First, of course, I'm deeply honored to be in a row of other persons that had got previously this award, and these are all outstanding people in this biomass society. Of course, I saw this list, but I could not find a lady in this list. It's only men up to now. So next time, perhaps there is a chance for a lady. Sorry that I'm a man. Secondly, the Linneborn Prize had a special importance for me personally, because you heard from Wim that Johannes Linneborn was a pioneer in gasification. He worked on gasification many decades before I started to think about gasification. But I'm working on gasification, and I'm also sure gasification will be a key technology. If you heard the four keynote lectures this morning, three of them were tackling seriously gasification is one of the key technology to convert this solid biofuel into a more homogeneous gas, and you can do a lot of this with this gas. And so I feel as real successor of Linneborn, he was a pioneer, and I feel also a little bit of pioneering work we have done and we will do also in the future. It's funny, as I wake this morning, I remembered sometimes, many years ago, my doctor said to me, as I had some problems, he said, you have a cycle of 10 years where you have highlights and then it goes down and then comes up again. So it's more or less through, as this doctor says. So in 1982, I finished my PhD. In 1992, I make my habilitation to become a docent. In our region, it's a docent to become a lecturer, more or less. In 2002, you would expect I become professor. No, it was already 1997, but in 2002, Güssing started operation, and it was also a big success, of course. And I was thinking, what will happen 2012, next 10 years? So I think I know it now. It is this award I got as highlight for my professional career. So this award encouraged me for further and forth in the work of bioenergies for another 10 years. I'm not so young as I look like, but 10 years are still available for my active work. And to follow some visions from Johannes Linneborn, of course, in an adequate and modified way for the time now and for the future. As I already said, I'm sure biomass had a bright future, and also I wish this conference here a bright future. Thank you once more for giving me this very prestigious award. Thank you very much.